station things, and I just run sprinklers on them in the summertime all summer long. And you can't give them too much water in summer around here. If you've never killed an orchid, you're not growing orchids. Because I have killed my share, trying to figure out what a plant needs. And after I've killed something once or twice, I usually don't try that one again. But occasionally I have a desire that I want to do that plant, and I've figured something different I can try, so I'll do that.
Well, I don't know for sure. I've got a few weird ones that, you know, I have a lot of dendrobiums, a lot of cat lilies. And then I have some other strange ones that, but that's mainly what I grow. These cat lilies and dendrobiums. But they don't know it. So I don't publicize that one, but I like the brand. And there's some other ones that are in here, like this plant here. I have not got it to prove yet. But this one was named by a grower who bred orchids. He bred this orchid, and it's named L.C. Karen Tobias, and after my wife for her 50th birthday. And so it's a blue flower, and I'm going to get it to bloom, if not this year, I will get it to bloom next year. I guess it's a goal of mine to get that one to flower right. Go somewhere else that I like.